it just makes me feel like I need to hide away. It does make me feel ashamed because it just makes me feel like I am less of a person when my skin is like this. I've suffered from acne since I was around 14 years old. I've got it on my face and my back, but predominantly my face. It's really bumpy and dry, and sometimes it can bleed. Sometimes it'll just leak. Normally, I just moisturise in the morning, just because I find it quite cooling when my skin's been really sore. Sometimes it'll help with quite a lot of the dry patches I've got. I don't feel like I can live a normal life at the moment. It really could not be worse than it is right now. And I can't escape it because I feel it. It's painful. I can't touch my face. If I ever look in a mirror, I see it. It's constantly on my mind. My confidence is through the floor over my skin. People have shouted things at me in the street when it's been really bad. I'm not getting the help that I need. This needs to be fixed.
Hi, you've got an appointment with Dr. Emma.
Okay, brilliant. Take a seat, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
So I am at a point where I am just thinking, it's my hope for getting my skin fixed at this point is pretty low.
Hi, is it Kayleigh?
Yeah, hello.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Dr. Emma.
Nice to meet you.
You want to come with me?
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm excited.
You're excited?
Yeah.
So tell me what's been happening with your skin.
For the past, I'd say, 8 years or so, I've suffered with quite bad acne.
And it looks quite painful.
It is. It's scarred,
it's
sore,
it's
painful. It's just every bit of my life is affected by this.
Yeah. So what kind of things have you tried so far?
The list is huge. I didn't realise how long the list was until I had to dig it out of myself. But the main one I have tried was I used to try Acne when I was 19, and I was on that for 3 months. They took me off it because contraceptive I was on at the time gave me really low mood. I suppose they just didn't want to risk my moods getting worse by either keeping me on it or increasing the dose. So I was still seeing dermatology, trying to explain. Yeah. Even years after that, I'm in a completely different position now. Like, I'm out of uni, I've got a job, like, my moods are lifted, can we try it again? And it's just a constant, no, we're done, there's nothing else we can do, like...
Yeah, that's a shame.
Yeah.
Do you have problems with anxiety or depression?
I'd say at the... when my acne's at its worst, my anxiety's quite high. I'd say 90% of the reason why my moods are always low.
The injectable contraceptive is very much associated in some people with low moods. Mm. So is very severe acne, and more so these two things than the isotretinoin itself. From all of the studies that we've got on isotretinoin, that in a very, very small number of people, it can cause a change in mood.
Yeah.
But those people tend to be people who have already had psychiatric conditions and not somebody who feeling anxious or depressed because of the way their acne is making them feel.
So
it's a different group of people. And what do your friends and family say to you about your skin? Are they supportive?
My support system's so solid, but there's only so much words can do at this point. There's only so much, it's okay. Like,
yeah.
I don't want to get...
That's why it's good you're wearing really cool glasses. people want to be nice, don't they?
Yeah.
But you also know there is a problem.
Yeah.
And we need to fix it.
It's not nice because I am more than my skin. Do you know what I mean?
Can I have a look at your skin? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So what we can see looking at your skin is that we've got these little tiny pustules. Mm-hmm. We've got bigger nodules. Mm-hmm. We've got deeper cysts.
Yeah.
We've got deeper scars.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got a large spot here. Mm-hmm. And then on this side, we've got a combination of a whole lot of stuff going on, haven't we? We have the little pustules. We have these deeper scars, this big cystic lesion.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what happens in these areas is that you've got a follicle that's very, very, very thick. And it becomes a cyst-like lesion. And then, unfortunately, it causes a lot of inflammation, which makes a scar. But the cyst is still there. Yeah. Your whole general skin has just got this redness to it. Then I am not happy. No. I am angry. Okay, the type of acne that you have is one that's going on to make these deep-seated cysts and nodules. Yeah. I would like to put you on the isotretinoin tablets.
Yeah.
And we'll go through all of the potential side effects of those. The next thing that you need to have is some injections into these active ones that you've got here. They need to be shrunk down a bit and the inflammation needs to settle. How does all that sound?
Absolutely great. This is actual music to my ears.
Big smile on your face.
Yeah.
Does that, are you crying with sadness or happiness?
Joy.
Happy then.
It's just, it's nice to be listened to, you know, and just know there's actually an end. Like, this is the start of the end.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't think there's many more things that would mean more than this to me at this point. Thank you.
Well, it's a long road.
Yeah.
But I'm on your side and we're definitely going to get there, okay?
Yeah, thank you.
Kayleigh has severe acne and she needs our most serious treatment to tackle it. She'll go onto isotretinoin and with combination with the medication, these injections will reduce the size of the cysts, the inflammation, and we should start to see results pretty quickly. Okay, so I'm gonna do this one here on the cheek first of all, okay? So sorry about this, you feel a wee tiny scratch. Well done, very good. Good job, well done. Good job. Well done indeed. That's great. Well done. Okay, wriggle your fingers really fast like you're playing Rachmaninoff on the piano. Great job. Well done indeed. Woohoo! You did it! How was your journey down?
Actually, it was only 2 hours, so it wasn't too bad, actually.
Oh, that's okay.
It was a quiet train, so.
Come on in and have a seat, Kayleigh.
Thank you.
So, have you got any makeup on?
No.
Nothing?
Nothing. Just moisturiser.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, what a difference.
I know.
Well, wow. This looks really amazing.
Yeah. Thank
you. You're gorgeous.
Thanks. Oh, God.
I know you like a compliment.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, no, I can't. I'm not that comfortable with my skin where I can take them just yet, but we'll
you need to learn because you're going to get them.
Yeah, I know. We'll get there in the end.
How do you feel whenever you're looking in the mirror and catching a glimpse of your skin?
Definitely a difference in terms of, I know it's flatter. Like, I remember when I used to, like, turn my head to the side and I could literally see, like, the bumps in my skin, whereas now anything that is there is just scarring now. But I know in my head that will pass.
I can see the definition coming over your cheek.
Yeah.
So you've got this lovely shape that comes from the temple into the cheek. I can see it. It's really perfect.
Yeah, it's definitely getting there.
And now the moment of truth for me, because I want to get in and have a feel of your skin. Is that all right?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to start at this forehead, which is now little bits of scar, which will eventually flatten out. Mm. But there's no cysts, none.
No.
All of these spots here have cleared. This one here is still active.
Yeah.
This is still going for it. Sorry for squeezing it.
Sorry, that's been going for years.
Yeah, we might need to inject that one again. Mm. There are a few pustules and papules that are still inflamed, and you've got a couple of cysts that are still remaining.
Yeah.
But actually, the majority of what we're seeing on the skin is a little bit of the swelling and the redness and the side effects of actually the isotretinoin. Yeah. But we'll deal with those and persist forward for the next few months while we clear up the rest of these spots that are here.
Yeah.
After months of effort on Kayleigh's part, it's been amazing to see her back in the clinic. As soon as I saw her, I just thought, wow, she's benefiting from this already and things are only going to continue to get better. And it is a long slog because, you know, this has been going on so long for you, Kayleigh, like decades, essentially. Yeah, it's a long time.
It definitely feels a lot better. So I can definitely see it's flattening out, especially on my jawline.
And before it was really quite painful.
There's no pain anymore, really. The only pain is the dryness, if anything. But in terms of cysts, I've not had one since when I was down in January and I had that one there, or there, wherever it was.
Good, you can't even remember.
Yeah, I know. But that's the last one that I had.
Because I feel you're a bit like a different person, actually, from whenever you feel like a little butterfly starting to emerge.
A little bit, yeah.
I kind of feel like that for you.